have been doing problem based on sum of first n terms of NAP. Now we'll move to another type of questions in which we have given sum of 3, 4, or 5 consecutive terms of NAP, and we have to find those consecutive terms. So let us understand how to solve this type of question with the help of some question, and we'll understand how we can solve this type of questions. Okay. So here I have taken one problem in which we question is find 3 consecutive terms in an AP whose sum is 27 and their product is 504. Suppose first consecutive term is A, second is second, and common difference is D, then next term will be A plus D, and next term will be A plus 2D. Here we have to add 3 consecutive terms. So 3 consecutive terms will be A, A plus D, A plus 2D. So when you add these numbers, A plus A plus D plus A plus 2D, what will happen? You will end up with A plus A, 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 A. I have told you many times that we can add variables of same class. So we will add A with A only and D with D only. So here we have A terms A, 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 3 A terms. So it will be 3A plus, now come to D terms, we have D terms here and here. So D plus 2D, it will be 3D. Okay. Now it is given 27. Okay. So now, in this type of question, it is advisable to take terms like this. If first term is A minus 3, second term, we are taking 3 consecutive terms, A minus D, A and A plus D. You can also take A, 3 consecutive terms, A, A plus D, A plus 2D. But it is more convenient to take 3 consecutive terms as A minus D, A, A plus D when you are dealing with 3 consecutive terms of NAP. This is when we are dealing with 3 consecutive terms of an AP. One question must be arising in your minds, that it is more convenient to take 3 consecutive terms like A minus D, A, A plus D. Why it is not convenient to take A, A plus D, A plus 2D? So this is very important to understand. So when you add A minus D, A or A plus D, what will you end up with? Suppose you are adding A minus D plus A plus A plus D. In this case, if you observe, this D and this D will be cancelled out. Here it is minus D, here it is plus D. So you are end up with 3A only. Okay? And 3A will be 27. Therefore, A will be 27 by 3. And 3, 9s are 27. So A is 9. In this case, we are getting A plus D. If you take common 3 from here, if you take 3 common from here, so you can 3A plus D will be 27. Therefore, A plus D will be 27 by 3, and which is 9. Okay. So now you can easily justify that when you have to add 3 consecutive terms of AP, then it is more convenient to take 3 consecutive terms as A minus D, A and A plus D. So now I will tell you when you have the sum of 4 consecutive terms of NAP, then what terms you will take 4 consecutive terms, and we have, if you have to add sum of 5 consecutive numbers, then what we'll do, we'll understand this. Okay, we have just talked about that when we are given the sum of 3 consecutive terms of NAP, then it is advisable to take, or it is more convenient to take terms like A minus D, A plus D. Why we are, it is more convenient or advisable to take A minus D, A or A plus D? Because when you add these 3 consecutive numbers, then D and D will be cancelled out and we will left with equation in A only. So you can, we will easily find A. Okay. So in case of 3 consecutive terms, now suppose in some other question, if suppose you are given with the sum of 4 consecutive terms of NAP, then what we will do, let's see that. Suppose you are given 4 consecutive terms, if you are taking A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D, these are the terms. If you add these 4 consecutive terms of NAP, what will happen? Let's see. If you add A plus D plus A plus 2D plus A plus 3D, what will happen? Okay. Now let's add the 4 terms. So I have told you many times that similar class of variable are added or subtracted together. So we can add A with A only and D with D terms only. Okay. So A. So A plus A plus A plus A is 4A. Okay. Now come to D terms. We have D terms here, D terms here, D terms here. So D plus 2D is 3D. 3D plus 3D is 6D. So we are end up with 4A plus 60. But our most convenient way is to cut the terms with D. Okay, so it is more advisable to take the terms as A minus D, A plus D, A plus 3D, A plus A minus 3D. Okay, so what will happen when we will take, when we will take the 4 consecutive term like A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus 3D, what will happen? Let's see. When you add these numbers, suppose you are adding this number A minus D, we have this number A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus 3D. When you add these numbers, means we are adding 4 consecutive numbers plus A plus D, A plus 3D. Then let's concentrate on A terms. Here we have A, here we have A, here we have A, here we have A. Now concentrate on D terms. So 3D minus D plus D, 3D. Means this minus 3D and this plus 3D will be cancelled out. Okay. Here minus D, here it is plus D. So this 2 will be cancelled out. So we are left with terms containing A only. Okay. So it is more advisable to take like this when you have given sum of 4 consecutive terms of NAP. Okay. So in case of four consecutive terms of NAP, we'll assume terms like this, 4 consecutive terms. We'll take term like A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D and A plus 3D. Okay. Now Suppose you are given the sum of 5 conjugative terms of NAP. If you take like a plus d, a plus 2d, a plus 3d, and a plus 4d, then what will happen when we add these 5 conjugative terms of NAP? Now let's see. A plus d plus a plus 2d, a plus 3d, and a plus 4d. Okay. Now concentrate on a terms first of all. We have here a. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It means it is 5a plus. Now concentrate on d terms. D. So when you add d plus 2d is 3d, 3d plus 3d is 6d, 6d plus 4d is 10d. So it will be 10d. Okay. So in this, so it is more convenient to take, or it is more advisable to take if you are given the sum of 5 conjugated terms. So you have to take terms like this. I am writing here a minus 2d, a minus d, a plus d, a plus 2d. When you add these 5 conjugative terms of NAP, a minus 2d, a minus d, a plus d, a plus 2d, then here 2d minus 2d minus d means minus 3d. And d plus 3d means when you add minus 2d or plus 2d will be cancelled out. Here minus d and plus d will be cancelled out. So we will end up with terms containing a only. Okay. So in case of 5 conjugated terms, we will take terms as a minus 2d, a minus d, a plus d, a plus 2d. Okay. We have just understood that if you have given the sum of 3 conjugated terms, then it is more convenient to take, or it is more advisable to take terms like a minus d, a and a plus d. And reason being, we have to eliminate the terms of d, so we will end up with the terms containing a only. Okay. Now, in the similar way, in case of 4 conjugative terms, we will take terms as a minus 3d, a minus d, a plus d, a plus 3d. So the reason is same. We have to eliminate the d terms, and we have to end up with a terms only, okay, or terms containing a only. In case of 5 conjugative terms, we are taking the terms a minus 2d, a minus d, a plus d, a plus 2d. Reason is same. Here we have to eliminate d terms, the terms containing d. So we are end up with terms containing a only. Reason is same in all three cases. One thing is very important here. If you have closely observed, that you can easily say, or you can say that in case of odd conjugative terms, the middle term we are taking as a. Now in case of 5 conjugate terms, the middle term is we are taking as a. And common difference is what? In this case, common difference is difference between 2 conjugative terms, and difference is what? A plus d minus a. Here it is common difference is d only. Okay. Now come here, now come to 5 conjugate terms. Here difference is a plus d minus a is d, a plus 2d minus a plus d is d. So in this case also the common difference is d. Okay. Now let us have a look on 4 conjugative terms. Here it is a minus 3d, a minus d, a plus 3d. So if you understand the term, middle term is 2 middle terms, a minus d and a plus d. Here we have 2 middle terms. In case of odd conjugative terms of NAP, we have middle terms a, and in case of even consecutive terms of NAP, we have two middle terms A minus D and A plus D. And in this case, if you find, common difference will be what? A plus D minus A minus D. If in this case, A plus D minus A minus D. When we have terms more than one terms, after minus sign, then we have to keep the terms in bracket. So keep in mind, if there is sign, minus sign before that, then, and you have more than one terms, then you have to keep those terms in bracket. So now solve this. A plus D minus into plus is minus A, minus into minus is plus, and 1 into D is D. Okay. So A will cancel out, so common difference is 2D in this case. Here common difference will be 2D. A plus 3D minus A plus D will be 2D. It means when you are subtracting, when you are finding difference between two consecutive terms, we are getting 2D. Okay, here common difference is not D, here common difference is 2D. Okay, in case of all positive numbers, all consecutive terms of NAP, we have common difference D. In case of even consecutive terms of NAP, common difference, we will take common difference 2D, and middle term will be A minus D and A plus D. Okay.
No more spending your energy and money on coaching classes or missing classes for rain, for rally, and any other nonsense. Subjects covered by multiple teachers with repeat telecasts. Doubts, concepts, applications, no problem. All explained through great and significant animation. So sit back comfortably in your home and watch Study Spectrum TV channel.
Start with the question properly. Find three consecutive terms in an AP whose sum is 27 and their product is 504. We have to find three consecutive terms. Okay. So we'll assume three consecutive terms as, because here we have three consecutive terms, it means it is odd. So we'll take middle term A and common difference D. So A plus D, and this is middle term, so other term will be A minus D. I have just discussed that if you have odd consecutive terms, odd number of consecutive terms, then middle term is A and common difference is D. Okay. So sum of three consecutive terms means sum will be A minus D plus A plus A plus D. So what will it be? So A minus D plus A plus A plus D. D will be cancelled out. So you are left with 3A. But according to question, sum is 27. It means 3A is equal to 27. Therefore, A will be 27 by 3, it is 3 9s are 27, so 9. Now come to the second part of second condition of the question. Here their product is 504. Product means multiplication. So in question we have given their product means A minus D into A into A plus D is 504, and we have just got A equal to 9, so we'll substitute here. So A is 9 minus D into 9 plus D is equal to 504. So all these terms are in multiplication. So here 9 is in multiplication, then on other side it will come in division, or it will come in denominator. So 9 minus D into 9 plus D is equal to 504 upon 9. Okay. So let's try. 9 5 ja 45. So 5 minus 5 4. So 9 6 ja 54. So it will be 56 times. 9 56 times is 504. Got it? So 9 minus d into 9 plus d equal to 56. So here it is a minus b into a plus b. A minus a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. But at the place of a we have 9, and at the place of b we have d. Here at the place of a we have 9, and at the place of b we have d. So it will be a square minus b square. It means it becomes 9 square minus d square equal to 56. Okay. 9 square is 81. So 9 into 9 is 81 minus d square equal to 56. We have to find d. So we'll take, we'll keep d terms on one side, and without d terms, it means constant term on other side. So here it is minus d square. So we'll take d square on the right hand side, and we'll take 56 on left hand side. Okay. So 81 minus, because here it is plus 56, so on other side it will be minus 56. And here it is minus d square, so on the right hand side it will be plus d square. So 81 minus 56, it will be 25 equal to d square. Therefore, d will be plus minus root under 25. So d will be plus minus 5. Okay. We have got d, two values of d, one is plus 5 and other is minus 5. So we'll write, just we have find a equal to 9 and d equal to, d has two values, plus minus 5. So we'll take, one case we'll take d equal to 5, and another case we'll take d equal to minus 5. Okay. So we have number as a minus d, a and a plus d. Here we have number as a minus d, a and a plus d. Okay. So a is 9 and d is 5. So it will be 9 minus 4 is 9 minus 5 is 4. Okay. Second term is a, so a is 9, so it will be 9 only. The third consecutive term is a plus d. It will be 9 plus 5 and it will be 14. Okay. Now come to case 2, where d is minus 5. Okay, so a is 9 minus 5. So 9 minus into minus is plus 5, that will be 14. Okay, a is 9, and third consecutive number, which is a plus d, will be 9 plus, at the place of d will put minus 5. So 9 plus into minus is minus 5, so 9 minus 5 is 4. So we have got two sets of number. One is 4, 9, 14. One is 4, 9, 14. And other is 14, 9, 4. Okay, so these are the answers. The terms can be 4, 9, 14 or 14, 9, 4. Okay. Now move to the another question based on sum of 3, 4 or 5 terms, consecutive terms of an AP. Now the question is, find 4 consecutive terms in AP whose sum is minus 54 and the sum of first and third term is minus 30. So when we were discussing the concept ki which terms we have to take when we have given four consecutive term, and I have told you in that case middle term is a minus d comma a plus d. We have two middle terms in case of even number of terms, even number of consecutive terms. So middle term will be a minus d and a plus d, and common difference will be 2d. Okay, so middle term will take consecutive terms as a minus d and a plus d. Here these two are middle terms and common difference is 2d. So a plus d plus 2d will be a plus 3d and a minus 3d. Okay, why we are taking this? The reason is same, we have already discussed that the d terms will be vanished out, so we will left with terms containing a only. Okay, so now according to question, the sum of all these four consecutive terms is sum is minus 54. So a minus 3d plus a minus d plus a plus d plus a plus 3d is minus 54. Okay, so this minus 3d and plus 3d will be cancelled out. Here minus d and plus d will be cancelled out. So we are left with terms containing a only. So what here we have a here, 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 here. So a plus a plus a plus a. So we are adding a four times, it will be 4a equal to minus 54. Therefore, a will be minus 54 upon 4. So 2 2s are 4 and 2 27s are 54. So it will be minus 27 by 2. Okay. Now we have got a, but we have to find a minus 3d, a minus d, a plus d, a plus 3d. So we require a and d both. But right now we have got only a. So we'll use the second condition of the question to find d. Okay. So what is the second condition? Sum of first and third term is minus 30. Means we have first term a minus 3d and third term, first, second, third. Third is a plus d. So sum is minus 30, means a minus 3d plus a plus d is minus 30. Okay, so a is here and a is here, so a plus a is 2a, and we have d terms here and here, so minus 3d plus d. Okay, so here both d terms have opposite sign, so we'll subtract both terms. So 3 minus 1 is 2, but we'll put the sign of larger number. So here larger number 3 has 3d has minus sign, so it will write minus 2d. Okay, equal to minus 30. Okay, so take here it is 2, here it is 2, take 2 as common, a minus d equal to minus 30. Okay, so here 2 is in multiplication with this whole term a minus d, so therefore a minus d will be minus 30 by 2, because on left hand side it is in multiplication, so on right hand side it will come in division or in denominator. So a minus d will be minus 30 upon 2, and 2 15 is 30, so minus 15. Okay, so now we'll put the value of a and we'll find d. So value of a is minus 27 by 2 minus d equal to minus 15. Okay, got it? So we'll keep d terms on one side and constant terms on other side. So let's do here. So minus 27 by 2 minus d equal to minus 15. So we'll take d terms on right hand side. So it will become plus d, and we'll take minus 15 on left hand side. So it will become plus 15, because sign will change. When we change the side, then sign is changed. So minus 27 by 2 plus 15 equal to d. Okay. So here it is 1. So we will take LCM as 2. 2 or LCM of 2 and 1 is 2. So 2 2's are 1, and 1 into minus 27 is minus 27 plus 2 divided by 1 is 2, and 2 into 15 is 30. Therefore, d will be what? 30 minus 20. Minus 27 plus 30. Both have opposite signs, will subtract, but put the sign of larger number. So here it is plus. So 30 minus 27 is 3, and we'll put the sign of larger number. So it will be plus 3. So plus 3 upon 2. Okay. So we have found A as 27 minus 2 minus 27 by 2, and D as 3 by 2. Okay. Thus, we have got A minus 27 by 2 and B 3 by 2. So, but we have to find 4 conjugative terms in AP. So, terms are A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D, and A plus 3D. Let's find them. So, here A minus 3D. A is minus 27 by 2 minus 3 into 3 by 2. So it will be minus 27 by 2 minus 3 into 3 is 9. So minus 9 by 2. So to simplify this, we'll take LCM. So we'll take LCM as 2. So minus 27 minus 9, because when we take 2 divided by 2 is 1, so 1 into minus 27 is minus 27, minus 2 divided by 2 is 1, and 1 into 9 is 9. So it is minus 27 minus 9. Both have same sign, so we'll add both of the number. So my 27 plus 9 will be 36. Since both of the number has minus sign, so we'll put the sign minus there. So it will be minus 36 upon 2. 2 18 is 36, so it will be minus 18. Okay. Now we have to find A minus D. So A minus D, we'll put the value of A minus 27 by 2 minus 3 by 2. Again, we will take LCM 2, so it will be minus 27 minus 3. Again, we have both number having same sign, so we'll add both of the number. So 27 plus 3 is 30, and sign is, we'll put sign minus, because both number have minus sign. So it will be minus 30 upon 2. 2 15 are 30, so minus 15. Okay. Now A plus D. A is minus 27 by 2, and D is 3 by 2. So we'll take LCM 2. So it will be minus 27 plus 3. In this case, both number have opposite sign, one is minus and another having plus sign. So we'll subtract both of the numbers. So 27 minus 3 will be 24, but we'll put the sign of larger number as minus sign, so it will be minus 24 upon 2. 2 2 12s are 24, so it will be minus 12. And finally, we have to find a plus 3d. So a plus 3d, a is minus 27 by 2 plus 3 into, and d is 3 by 2. So it will be minus 27 by 2 plus 9 by 2. Minus 27 by 2 plus 9 by 2. Here 2 and 2, so LCM of 2 and 2 will be 2. Okay, so minus 27 plus 9. Here both have opposite signs, so we'll subtract both of the numbers. So 27 minus 9 will be 18. But we'll put the sign of larger number, so minus 18 by 2, 2 9s are 18, so it will be minus 9. Thus we have got four consecutive terms as minus 18, minus 15, minus 12 and minus 9. Minus 15, minus 12, minus 9. Okay, thus we have got four consecutive terms.
No more spending your energy and money on coaching classes or missing classes for rain, for rally, and any other nonsense. Subjects covered by multiple teachers with repeat telecasts. Doubts, concepts, applications, no problem. All explained through great and significant animation. So sit back comfortably in your home and watch Study Spectrum TV channel.
General life examples of consecutive terms in AP. Okay, the question is, in winter the temperature at hill station from Monday to Friday is in AP the sum of the temperatures of Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday is zero, and the sum of temperatures of Thursday and Friday is 15. Find the temperatures of each of the 5 days. Okay. So here we have Monday, we have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. Here we have 5 consecutive days. It means we have to take 5 consecutive numbers of AP or numbers in AP. So I have told you, when we have odd numbers of consecutive terms, then middle term is A and common difference is D. So here middle is A and common difference is D. So we will say A plus D, A plus 2D. And Tuesday will be A minus D, and this will be A minus 2D. Okay, so these are the temperatures at the respective days. On Monday it is A minus 2D, on Tuesday it is A minus D, on Wednesday it is A, on Thursday we have temperature A plus D, and on Friday it is A plus 2D. Now come to the question. The sum of the temperatures of Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday means Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday. So sum will be what? A minus 2D plus A minus D plus A is equal to what? 0. It is 0. So now here we have A. So it will be 3A. Now come to D terms. d d, so minus 2d minus d, it will be both have same sign, so we will add but put the sign of sign minus, so minus 2d minus d will be minus 3d is 0. So we'll take 3 as common from here, so a minus d is 0, here 3 is multiplied with the whole term a minus d, so a minus d will be 0 divided by 3, so a minus d will be 0 divided by 3, and 0 divided, 0 is divided by any numbers, it becomes 0, but denominator should not be 0, means 0 divided by any number other than 0 will be 0, so it is 0. It means a minus d equal to 0, so a equal to d. Okay, so we have got a equal to d, this is equation number 1. Now come to the second condition of the question, because to find a minus 2d, a minus d, a plus d, a plus 2d, we need to know a and d both. Okay, so now come to the second condition of the question. The sum of temperatures of Thursday and Friday is 15. So Thursday and Friday is 15. So we'll write a plus d plus a plus 2d is 15. Okay. So here we have a here, so it will be 2a, and we have d terms here and here, so d plus 2d will be 3d, will be 15. Okay, but according to question 1, a is equal to d, so we'll substitute, you will find the equation in variable 1, so we'll substitute a at the place of d, so it will be 2a plus 3, and at the place of d we'll substitute a, so 3a will be 15, so 2a plus 3a will be 5a equal to 15, therefore a will be 15 by 5, so a will be 5 3 is 15, so a will be 3. So a is 3, so d will be also 3, because a and d are equal, so d is also 3. Okay, now we have to find the temperatures on each of the 5 days. So on Monday, we'll start with on Monday, temperature is a minus 2d. On Monday it is a minus 2d. Okay, so a is 3 and d is 3, so 3 minus 2 into 3, so it will be 3 minus 6 will be minus 3, because both numbers have a positive sign, so we'll subtract and we'll put the sign of larger number, and larger number has minus sign. Okay, now on Tuesday temperature is a minus d. On Tuesday temperature a minus d, and it is 3 and d is also 3, so it will be 3 minus 3 is 0. Okay, now on Wednesday it is a, so a is 3, so a will be 3. Okay, now on Thursday temperature is a plus d, so on Thursday temperature is a plus d, we have got a equal to 3 and d equal to 3, so 3 plus 3 will be 6. Now on Friday temperature is a plus 2d, so 3 plus 2 into 3, So 3 plus 6, that is 9. So A minus 2D, temperature on Monday is A minus 2D, it is minus 3. Temperature on Tuesday is A minus D, and it is 0 we have just got. It is minus 3, it is 0, it is 3. On Thursday it is 6, and on Friday it is 9. Okay, so temperature on the each of the 5 days is minus 3, 0, 3, 6, 9. And these temperatures are in AP. Why they are in AP? Because my difference 0 minus 0 minus minus 3 is 3, 3 minus 0 is 3, 6 minus 3 is 3, 9 minus 3, 6 is 3. In all cases we are getting difference between two consecutive terms same, so these temperatures are in AP.